boy who called himself Enominat. Could he really be Velvet's younger brother?
It could have been an illusion intended to torment her. Don't you agree, Eleanor?
I do. Velvet's objective is avenging her brother, after all. We've all seen how strongly she feels about it. I find it hard to believe that the one so dear to her is still alive.
I don't know what powers Enominat possesses, but I think that really was her little brother. Velvet was able to see past Melchior's illusions. But look at her now. I just don't want to believe that the real Lafi could do such a thing.
Could it be possible that Enominat was reborn into her brother's body?
I don't know. But if that was the case, I'm not sure Velvet would be in so much agony.
Yes, I guess. Enominat actually being Velvet's brother. It makes a twisted sort of sense. But it's too awful.
But you're going for platinum. I'm assuming you're going for platinum.
Is this?
Look!
Hey, stay with me. I'll get someone right away.
It's okay. I'm tired.
Have you been journeying long, then?
10 years. My master entrusted everything to me. But I couldn't do anything.
10 years?
My wings are weak. It doesn't matter anymore.
I see. If you've been working that hard, you surely need a break. I just happened to get my hands on some prickle boar meat. I'll be cooking up a stew for dinner, but would you care to join me?
Huh? No, I...
All I have on me now is this apple. Here. Once your belly is full of warm food, you'll be able to pick yourself back up. I can feel it. Your body is shouting, I want to live.
I'm a disgrace. I don't deserve to live.
Is life something you have to earn? To deserve?
Well...
These feelings are natural. You eat when you're hungry and cry when you're sad. Feeling these things is proof that we're alive.
Alive?
What's your name? Mine is Celica. Celica Crow.
I'm an exorcist. Artoria. No, Arthur. I'm Arthur.
Artorias!
What in the world was that?
Rokuro! Aizen!
You saw it too then?
Sure did. Artorias. And he called himself Arthur.
I've heard of this. The Earth in Historia. They say that events on the world's surface cast imprints on the Earth pulse that runs below.
In other words, an illusion of the past.
It's not an illusion. That was my sister. So, you managed to fool her too, is it? Yes. Yes, that must be it. That's why she freed me from the prison.
Rokuro, have you recovered from your wounds?
Yep. Tough as nails. That's old Rokuro. I'm more worried about Velvet. Is she okay?
How could she be okay? Enominat is reborn, and it's her little brother.
A blade can't just be hard. It's gotta be flexible, or it'll snap the first time it meets an unexpected force. I misunderstood the true meaning of strength. and so did he.
Let's just worry about ourselves for now. This Earth Pulse is completely under Enominat's domain. We can think of it as an extension of his body.
Yeah, which means my power won't get us out of here.
Be wary. Enominat may be the one showing us these memories. Remember, he's after Velvet.
And the two types of malevolence inside her.
True. And we may be able to use that against him to get us out of here.
What are you saying? Just use her?
If it's necessary.
We have to keep moving. Nothing will be gained by staying here. And we ought to look for Magilu. Even she doesn't deserve to be stuck here forever.
Oh no.
On to battle!
Welcome home, Arthur.
Hi, Celica. I fixed the fence around the house.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. With the brigands stepping up their attacks, the town elders have been worried. But this should put their minds at ease.
No. If the brigands turn into demons, a mere fence won't stop them.
Hmm?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm pretty confident in my carpentry. And the other two?
Probably at the Cape again. I've warned them 100 times that it's dangerous.
Lafayette probably badgered Velvet into going. Don't worry, she'll watch out for him.
Yeah, I can only hope that this little one grows up to be as strong as she is one day.
Huh?
You're happy, I hope.
Of course I am. I never thought I could ever be this happy. I only wish I'd known earlier. I would have made something even nicer for you.
Oh, you made this for me?
Yeah. I put all my heart into it.
I'll cherish it always. It'll remind me of this happy day.
Let this serve as proof of our love. This I swear. I swear to protect you both with my life.
That's Lord Artorias's past.
Oh, that's rich! You mean you believe that tripe?
It's all a pack of lies. His smile, his promise, everything.
What we just saw, was that from before the opening?
Yeah. Celica was there, and Artorias still had use of his arm. It didn't look like he was an exorcist either.
I never would have thought Lord Artorias could smile so tenderly.
But he's since become an exorcist, taking on the mantle of shepherd and the weight of the world.
All because he lost his beloved wife.
I'd understand if you wanted to back out, but at this rate, I think the time is coming. Not much longer now.
It's coming.
Take a look at this.
The Scarlet Knight? This is Velvet's village.
So many of them. Celica, I'm coming!
It's too late! Take Velvet and Lafayette and run!
I can't do that! I want to have my life with you, with our child!
Arthur!
Celica! Why? Why couldn't I? Why couldn't I protect my own family?
Remember this moment well, Artorias. Humans are weak, filled with sin.
Melchior!
The people of this village offered you and your beloved family up to the demon brigands. A sacrifice so that they could escape and hide.
No, they wouldn't.
It happens often. The reason people act on is burdened by the weight of their sins. However, I have found a method to adjust their reason.
Our domain? What is this incredible power? Don't tell me the Imperium we've been searching for was here this whole time. These Molochim.
So they have been reborn. But be not deceived. They are not the same people you knew.
Why? Why must fate be so cruel?
It appears that Innominut's resurrection is incomplete. We must guide him until we understand why. I'll be taking these Molochim.
Wait! I'm sorry I couldn't keep my promise. I'll make things right. I'll abandon who I am. Nameless Moloch, I will forge a pact with you. I will put an end to all the pain in this world.
Do you have it in you? You who abandoned my friend's ideals and fled.
On the souls of my dead master, wife, and child. This I swear. My name is Artorias Colbrand. I have inherited the will and the strength of Claudin Asgard, former head of the Exorcists.
Very well. Let tonight's tragedy change fate and birth. Salvation.
That Moloch... it was... me! You don't remember?
Not at all.
They said you were reborn as a Moloch. That means... what exactly?
The soul of a human who passed away can, given the right trigger, be reborn as a Moloch.
You're saying that Artorias's child was reborn as Lafayette?
If what we saw was real, yes.
So the female Moloch that was born along with him was...
my sister's reincarnation. But I ate her long ago.
You didn't know, right?
I knew. I had already caught on to who Ceres really was.
Velvet.
But it doesn't matter. What does it change? I'll devour anything to fulfill my goal. My sister. My brother. Even the world. That's who I am. That's all I am.
Look! Over there!
An Earth Pulse Rift. We may be able to get out from there.
Arthur, there's something I'd like to speak to you about. Alone. Two souls possessing powerful resonance and free of malevolence. These must be sacrificed on the Scarlet Night.
Ah, yes. The ceremony to resurrect Innominat. You read my book.
I haven't fully mastered the ancient tongue yet, but I have read your notes. You wrote that if Innominat is resurrected, we can make a world free of demons.
7 years ago, a soul with strong resonance, my own unborn son, was sacrificed for that purpose. Now, Innominat's resurrection is half complete.
Because of that, everyone's resonance has grown stronger, enabling them to see demons.
Yes, that's the truth behind the opening.
So, if one more person is sacrificed...
Innominat's resurrection will be complete, and his power will spur the creation of many new exorcists.
And there is another Scarlet Knight very soon. Arthur, I must ask.
Lafayette.
Can't I be the sacrifice?
Tell me, why do you think that birds fly?
I think that birds fly because they must. Why else would they have wings if not to embrace the sky? I have wings too. Weak as they are. That's why I must fly. Now! If we miss this Scarlet Night, the next won't be for another 3 years. By then, I won't be alive.
Lafayette, why would you say such a thing?
The 12-year sickness. That's the name of my disease.
So you know.
I'm not afraid of being sick. But I don't want to just be a burden on everyone until I die. I couldn't take it.
Your wings are your will. And they are strong.
Lars. Please. You can't tell Velvet about this.
I promise.
I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Don't talk to me about will! About wings! Both of you! Together! You betrayed me!
hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right? Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
Shut up!
He fell further than this back at the shrine. I will have my revenge.
Revenge for Lafayette!
Lafayette knew so much more pain than I ever will. And still, I couldn't do anything for him. I'm sorry.
Shut up! It's a lie! A dirty lie! All of it! It's all their lies! And I believed it! Die! 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 Get out of my way, you disgusting monster!
What is this thing?
An amalgamation of multiple demons?
It's a killing flash!
But I'm this close! I want this! Form Zero! Thunder!
You're dead! Great
stuff! See this?
Whirling Serpent! Blade, here you go! Hot Panther! Green Jerry!
Oh!
Illusions! Farce? How callous. That farce is the true face of my sister. She hates, resents, devours, and kills. She tramples people, cities, everything, living only by her emotions. What an ugly, tainted soul.
It's not like that!
Nothing you say will matter. She knows. She knows if it's the truth.
He's right. Just think. Everything I did was baseless, arrogant. And even so, I still...
You hurt so many innocent people, didn't you?
More than I can count. I devoured and killed so many.
Without even knowing Arthur's true aims.
I destroyed people. I destroyed whole towns.
And worse yet, you didn't even show mercy to your own sister's reincarnation.
I ate her.
And despite all of that, I still love you, Velvet. That's why I chose to become a sacrifice. For you, sister. But think, if you try to stop the resurrection, wouldn't my death be all for nothing? To tell you the truth, I was terrified of dying. It was so dark.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You'll accept it, then? That everything you've done up until this point, all of it...
Yes. It was all for nothing, and for no one. I hurt so many people, all for no reason. I'm a monster.
If you've accepted it, you have to atone for your sins. Once I eat the final two malevolences inside you, I'll fully awaken. Give them to me. Give me your hatred, your despair. If you do, I can cleanse this world of all its pain. I had hoped that you could live in a world without pain and sadness. But you're a monster now. You don't belong there.
Go.
No!
If you don't, you'll die too for no reason.
No!
A twisted monster like me doesn't deserve to live. Don't you understand?
You're the reincarnation of the first sacrifice. Part of me. Don't worry, I'll devour you too.
Ah! copy set! Tell this self-absorbed idiot what she needs to hear!
Please, let me go.
Will you stop whining? No, I don't understand! You snap at people! You're scary! You tried to eat me! But you're also kind! And you're filled with life! I don't understand a single thing about you! But you gave me a name when I was a number! You gave me that compass! You taught me what it meant to be alive! That's why I care about you, Velvet! I'll protect you for my own sake!
Fee...
I don't care if you're malevolent or if it was pointless! If the world says it's a mistake to love you, I'll fight the whole world! I don't care how much pain you feel! It doesn't matter! A world without you, Velvet! Is the one thing I couldn't bear!
Let me go. My hand will... I love them all. I loved Luffy and Celica, Arthur, everyone. To have it all stolen from me. Why them? Why not me? It hurts so much!
Your despair, how is it gone?
A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
I finally understand how you felt. But the only one I can fight for is myself.
That's good enough. That's proof that you are truly alive.
How many times do you plan to destroy and rebuild your own heart, Muggy Lou?
We're on 107. Who was it, 108? I lost count. Not that I really care.
Pathetic fool. Did I not tell you it would require an iron will as indomitable as the very trees that live and die across millennia?
Like you, I suppose. Or that boy over there?
That is the foundation of an ideal world. One free from man's sins.
An ideal world, huh? You, kid. The boy who was your companion, Luffy said. He's alive. Chasing a terrifying demon girl, he has learned the immensity of the seas and weathered the dry wastes of the land. Those people, they're different from us. Despite the pain, the anguish, they embrace the life they've been given. They live, undaunted by the ugliness of the world!
So you're doing this all for them? Is that what this is?
Not even close. They aggravate me to my wit's end. Like stabs in the chest, over and over and over. And that's exactly why. That's why I intend to see how all of this ends. I won't be satisfied until I do.
Words bereft of meaning. You truly are my greatest failure.
Gosh, funny just how little I care. No!
Let me guess. We came at a good time?
You're late. Because of you, I had to have a really boring conversation.
So, you came face to face with Innominat. If so, then you must know that your quest for revenge is utterly meaningless.
Yeah, I did. I know why sadness fills the world. And I know how deep are the burdens of sin. I tried to abandon my memories of Arthur and Laffy, to cut myself off from it all, and end this tragedy. It's what they would have wanted.
Exactly. You do well to know your place.
But that's exactly why I can't forgive them. Not Artorias, not Innominat. I know my heart is ugly and full of contradictions, but those days we spent together in familial warmth, they're proof that that all of us, were truly alive. That's why, no matter how hard, no matter how sad it gets, I will take my vengeance to the very end!
Velvet!
Don't be a fool! Just give up and die like you want! It is your destiny to wallow in despair!
You take my family, turn me into a monster, and you want my soul too? Now who's being the fool? Remember this well. The Lord of Calamity never gives up, not even in the face of death.
Have you no shame for your sins, you unholy monster?
Let me in on this. I lost a bet, and I've got some anger to work out.
You sure you can fight in your condition?
I thought you'd never ask. I am the dastardly witch Magilu, scourge of self-righteous exorcists! Now face the wrath of Magilu Maven!
Fools, all of you!